Hey guys, welcome to Vindictus. I'm Kranisex, and this is the Lynn mastering tutorial guide. Now before I go through this, I want to actually just go through the skills, because after the Hurk video I got most of you guys' feedback, so this time I'm going to go through the skills first so you guys know, and it would actually make more sense if I went through the skills first. So one thing with Lynn is that you want to max her Thunder Leg first, which is her defense skill of course. You'll be using it a lot, and it costs less stamina as you level it up, so it's definitely worth it. Thunder Leg is this skill, it's just like the cartwheels. And then Little Rat here is a defense move, it's like a deflect. If you deflect something with it, you can teleport behind the target. You don't have to, but if you hit something else with a Little Rat after, you can you can perform Wind Step right after to go behind a target. I'll explain that more later. But one thing you want to know is that as you level up, you'll unlock more skills. Iron Machete is like the second tier smash, and then it can smash again into Fishtail Pull. Same with Broken Sword goes into Drunken Mantis, and Centipede Strike goes into Flying Guillotine. Now the thing is that you want to max, like, you want to get these skills, Fishtail Pole, Drunken Mantis, and the Flying Guillotine to at least rank C when you can, as soon as they unlock. Because at rank C, you can perform enhanced smashes. Like that, you'll see, like, the petals flying out. So I'll show you a comparison in just a bit. And then you also want Swift Assassin to rank A as fast as you can, because Swift Assassin is the main thing you'll be using most on bosses or markable targets. So when you mark a target, they'll have a shining star around them. It'll be either blue or yellow. Yellow is an enhanced one. And when you pop them with Five Finger Death is this. You can spam it as much as you like. Lynn doesn't have a throw key, so that's the throw key. The throw key is the Five Finger Death. And that's to activate the marks on an enemy. You can only mark a target up to 10 times, but at 10 marks, you get all your stamina back, which is ridiculous, because if you can land the 10 marks really fast and then pop them, you get all your stamina back. Doesn't matter what amount you have. So if you're a Dark Knight and you have like 300 stamina and you're down like all of it, and then you pop that on something, you'll get all of it back. Only on 10 marks. If it's 9 marks, you only get like 90 stamina back at rank A Swift Assassin, because every mark grants 10 stamina back. So you don't have to always stack 10 marks all the way. If you need the stamina in the middle of an attack and you're at 0, you can pop Five Finger Death at 0 stamina, and if it triggers, you get some stamina back and you can run away. So another thing you want to level is Stamina Mastery. I haven't really leveled mine that much, but I've noticed that the 144 range of stamina is a really, really good range where you can pretty much attack infinitely if you can stack the 10 marks repeatedly on a boss. So if you need more than that, that's like extra leeway for extra attacks to land the 10 marks. But generally, I find 144 stamina is a really good optimal area for the maximum amount of stamina that you need. So Battle Respiration, I always bring into rank A as fast as possible, because that just makes runs go faster. The one thing you want is probably you probably want Standing Endurance as high as possible, because unless you're really good at dodging, because Lynn doesn't have any super armor skills except for Jade FAQS. The thing about Jade FAQS is that she gets invincibility during this activation, and your SP becomes your health bar, except for like special attacks that are like unblockable or like magic effects. And then the rest are armor masteries. So like I remember in the Hurk video, a lot of people were asking like, oh, what armor do you wear? For Lynn, I would say actually like plate armor, like Nighthawk set and the Apocryphal set, is good for armor, but you do want light armor and a pirate set. And the one thing that I noticed that really, really helps Lynn is actually critical hits. Critical hits make like damage go up so much for this little girl, because the Swift Assassin is The Swift Assassin is they can trigger crits, and they're also smashes too. So you want these two up to, like, probably faster than like the other ones. So Swift Assassin rank A, you can leave Fishtail Pole, Drunk Mantis, and Flying Guillotine at rank C if you'd like. You'll be using Fishtail Pole a lot, and also Flying Guillotine a lot, and Centipede Strike a lot, which is the second smash and the fourth smash. The third smash is more like a spin, which I noticed I don't really use much. Oh, and you also be using Killer Dart a lot too. Killer Dart is to help buff. So I'll go into how Lynn like lands marks. All right, so here I'm gonna show you how to like do her enhanced smashes. Lynn is very easy to play, but extremely hard to master. Like, I find her to be a very difficult character, which is something I invite in terms of gameplay. I love difficulty, and so just take a notice here. Like, I'll do it twice. So this is like a regular smash. So if you'll notice, like, there was a spark on that last one. It wasn't meant to be do that, but those are regular smashes. Now what you want to learn with Lynn is how to do enhanced smashes. Enhanced smashes are really, really different. So I hope you'll notice the difference. Just have a look. Oh god. So you notice there's like spark and petals that fly out. Those are enhanced smashes. If you land those, you'll land golden marks, which do 20% more damage. The smashes themselves do 30% more damage, and you need to have these skills at rank C. The Flying Guillotine, Fishtail Pull, and Drunk Mantis to pull that off. If you don't have it, you can't do them yet. And which is why I told you to level those skills first and why I went through the skill build first. So I'll put them side by side together just so you can have a look and see the difference. Now, sometimes you see the spark, but you don't see the petals. The difference is that when you get the petals, like that, it means you did it correctly. But if you don't get the petals, then it means you did it incorrectly. Like, you can get the spark, but that doesn't mean you landed it. So the petals have to show up, and Lynn actually screams a little different. Get it right. But the thing is that landing that is hard because you want to... You have to let go of your smash button at the right time, right when the spark shows up. So it's really difficult when you do it that way. The way I do it though is that I actually press the smash button again just for a short delay and release it. It's extremely hard to explain it. I thought about this for a long time at how to tell you guys, but there's really no way to tell you other than to practice. Like, you have to figure out your own way to find your way of accomplishing that. There's no easy way for me to tell you how to do it. It's like a just input from Soul Calibur is the closest thing I could come to. For the way I do it is I go left click, right click, and then right click, let go really quickly. So it is very, very difficult. Like, even I still miss it sometimes. I can't get it 100% of the time. I get it like 90% of the time after like lots of practice. My one tip to you is that you want to stare at your character, and when you see that orange flash, you let go of your smash key when you see that orange flash, and that's how you get it. So that's the easiest way to like practice it, is to stare at your character. And once you see the orange flash when you press that smash button or hold down, there's two ways you can activate it. To activate the spark is to either hold down the smash key or press the smash key again for that during that second strike, and it will trigger if you hold it down long enough. And then that time frame in between where you have to let go is about 0.2 seconds or less. So you have about like a fifth of a second to let go. So the other way to land marks is with the long arm devil. It's an SP skill. I rank this up a lot because I use it a lot. It's this spitting skill. So when you have Jade Fox on, you can spam that as much as you like, and it upgrades it a little bit, but it does 20% less damage, but I don't care because the golden marks hit way more. I've seen other people, they just like spam Flying Snow the moment they turn on the Jade Fox, which I find to be really, really useless. I'll explain more on that later. So this is Flying Snow. And then this is, I use Chambers of Death a lot, which is this skill. I use it out of Jade Fox. It only costs one bar of stamina. But for Jade Fox, is a buff, the SP buff, and it makes you invincible for a short duration. I sometimes use Divine Spear if I have enough SP remaining, which is this. It upgrades blue marks to gold marks. So it's also really useful, and it also pierces through, so you can teleport through enemies if they're like charging you. So I'll show you, like, with Jade Fox, I normally like to do this combo, so I turn it on, and then like I do long arm devils like crazy. So like after that, that's like 9 hits, that'll be like, and then I finish it off with a Flying Snow. And then that generally hits really, really hard on any boss, and it's a lot of hits too, and they can all crit, and that's one of the things. So like for her ultimate, her ultimate is actually Jade Fox. It consumes your entire SP bar, but you can spam like your SP skills as much as you like. They cost a bit more, but when you take a hit, you also lose SP as well, but you don't lose HP. So it's like a shield, a temporary one. And that's what I do. And then when you blow Flying Snow at the end, the marks will go off and you'll get at least like 50-70 SP back. So that's a little bit of an explanation with landing marks. To land them really quick, you want to do a combo of killer dart and then into a flying guillotine and then a little rat back out, and then just repeat. So Lynn's a really strong hit and run character. I'll show you on Ikrium right now. So this is how I fight Ikrium. Alright guys, so I'm going to use Ikrium as an example here for battle. Normally I would do Shakar, but I've noticed it was very hard to see the enhanced smashes with Lynn because I'm a paladin, so the golden aura really just blocks out the petals. The enhanced smashes I'm talking about are of course the petal smashes that I showed earlier on the boat, side by side, so like that. And this is how like I do combat with Lynn on a fairly hard boss, I would say. Ikrium is pretty much kind of like that staple of difficulty in terms of like fighting enemies. So I want my killer dart buff, and I also want my little rat buff to get the Zen Furious Tiger. You always want this buff before any boss if you're doing like a map run, but if you're doing a raid, try to land that as fast as possible. And then if you can't land your Flying Guillotine is a bit of a greedy move, so you might want to do like the her uppercut, her Iron Arm and Golden Monkey. Iron Arm and Golden Monkey will always land a blue mark, but it's really quick though. Got a phone right in while I'm recording, god damn it. So Ikrium's a good example, and it's also at nighttime, so I can show you the enhanced smashes. So I quickly try to start off with a Flying Guillotine if he's not attacking me. And that's a little rat defense where I go behind. Like that. You have to press your dodge key and then press it again. So like I just keep appearing behind him. Or you can just like, you don't always have to do that. But let me just defend. So you can just like go backwards. One key thing to notice with the little rat is if you see that those circles, it means you blocked an attack successfully and you get this wind step buff. So don't confuse wind step with little rat. Wind step is an actual buff so that when you hit him again, you can actually just go straight behind him without deflecting anything. So that's what, like, I've noticed what most people are confused about. Like, Wind Step is a buff. It's not an actual technique. It's a buff that comes with Little Rat, and you have to block something in order to get it, and then you can just, like, go behind whenever, like that. Oh, but you don't want to do it, like, at a bad time like that. So I'm just gonna, like, attack him now, and I'll show you, like, how to land these golden marks really quick. Oh my god, and it just, like, went around him. So as you can tell, I always, like, do Little Rat after a smash to get away. And then I always follow back in with a Killer Dart. So at 6 marks, if I land a Flying Guillotine at this point, it'll basically land 4 marks. So for demonstration purposes, I'll try and land the 4 marks. This is the only attack that can land 4 marks in one smash, is the Flying Guillotine with the Zen Furious Tiger buff. That's if you'll let me land it. Oh god, it's so difficult to land it. Normally you would do a Killer Dart combo into it. So that's 10 marks. Boom! And then you just pop them. So another combo I'd like to do is I get 2 marks in, and then I turn on Jade Fox with a buff and use Wild Arm, and then do it twice, and then you'll get 10 marks, and then you can either pop it with the Flying Snow, or I'd like to add more damage by doing Chambers of Death, and then blow it. And that does an insane amount of damage, as you can tell there. That was like 3 bars of health on Ikrium there in the 50 to 69 version. I've tested it before with just the Flying Snow straight after Jade Fox, because Jade Fox makes Flying Snow do more damage based on how much SP you have remaining. But I've noticed that if you do the Long Arm Devil, and then you do, if you have leftover SP, you do Chambers of Death, you have more chances to crit. You have 10 golden marks on your target, and all those 10 marks can crit as well, and the Flying Snow hits about only 3.5k less per hit, and it hits 3 times. So you only losing about 7k damage for 10 marks for full SP, or no, full stamina, and it stuns the enemy twice. So the other thing is, if you land 10 marks on a boss and you pop them, it'll briefly stun the boss, 10 marks. If you do 9, it won't stun them. So 10 marks is also, that's the benefit of 10 marks, is that it'll stun the boss. The other thing is that with the amount of hits you're producing, you have higher chances to crit, and the crits do more damage overall. So, and you also stay in Vuln longer too. And Flying Snow is like only one direction, and if the boss circles around you or teleports away, you could possibly miss that attack as well. Whereas the Long Arm Devils are really fast, and it does full circles around you, which is why I don't blow Flying Snow right away, right after turning on Jade Fox. It's a complete waste. You get a brief stun on the boss, and that's all you get, and like 3 big hits, which is like 5 to 8k each if you crit, totaling for only about like 16 to like 24k of damage. Whereas the other way is in the slow motion, you'll notice that the damage numbers are a lot, and I'll add them all up for you. So here's the slow-mo. And use Wild Arm. And then do it twice. And then you'll get 10 marks. And then you can either pop it with the Flying Snow, or I'd like to add more damage by doing Chambers of Death, and then blow it. So guys, to recap, I'll show you all of Lynn's strengths on a Char duel here. As I told you, like in the Jane Fox combo, you want to do all the long arm devils. The skills I've already gone over at the beginning of the video. You use the ones that I use the most. I showed you which ones I leveled first. If you got more questions, just leave them down in the comments below. I'll be happy to answer them, just like that Hurk video. I always engage with you guys. So this will just be like a demonstration of and my level 80 friend there even thinks I'm pretty beast with Lynn, so I'll show you how fast I can kill Char. This is different than the end gameplay video. This is like when I've mastered her, or at least I think I've mastered her. Because I certainly land a lot of golden marks without having to use SP skills. So that's 10 marks, and there's 3 blue ones. I'll just use Divine Spear. Divine Spear upgrades 3 blue marks if you land all the hits anyways, so. Chambers of Death does 8 hits, and they hit really hard. Harder than Land's Spin to Win. Oh god. His head. Okay, you're just almost full SP. You don't need full SP, but I like to get full SP before I land Jade Fox, simply because it gives me more time to do more combos. When it's on, I actually don't care about getting hit most of the time. So it's 10 marks. That Char in 2 minutes and 40 seconds. Some minor mistakes, but either way, it's really, really fast if you can do gold marks. And gold marks hit really hard, and that's the damage potential with Lynn. So, those are the skills that I've leveled the most. You'll be using Fishtail Pull and Iron Machete the most, along with Centipede Strike and Flying Guillotine. And Little Rat and Killer Dart for the buffs. And Thunder Leg for defense. Little Rat is also defense, but Thunder Leg is like invuln defense. Alright guys, so I hope you just enjoy this ending cap here. I just want to reiterate that strengths for Lynn is critical. And I would actually say attack speed as well, because the faster you land these attacks, the faster you can build up those marks, and the faster you can return all your stamina on a 10 mark explosion. And I would suggest having at least 80 balance and higher. Most of her weapons are really high in base balance. So, and then for maximum stamina, you want at least about 140 max stamina. So I hope this really helped you. And here's just a bit of an ending, like, killing, like, montage for you. Alright guys, so thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time on another tutorial vid perhaps. If not, until then, bye bye for now.